Okay, I can't stop smiling because today's video is very special. It's not about me at all. As a matter of fact, it's a very heartfelt love story. You have two different people from different backgrounds, different cultures, who almost live on opposite sides of the world, who somehow, in this fast-paced moving world, ended up finding each other. They live 4,671 miles from each other, but somehow, they're with each other today. So basically, a really good friend of mine wants to do something special for his girlfriend of like 4 or 5 years. He had me reach out to her and ask her to be part of a video about interracial dating, but what she doesn't know is that Martin has something special planned for her. See, what Martin really wants to do, you know what, it'll be better if I just let Martin tell you.
So today we are shooting the vlog with Austin and Kenny, but you know, I've been with this beautiful girl for 5 years, and today my plan is not only to make a vlog about interracial couple, but I'm going to propose her, and I'm so excited, a little bit nervous, but let's do it.
Talk to Austin's parents?
Yes.
How did that go?
So I talked to her mom, I talked to her dad, and I met with both of them.
Okay.
Kind of like in a coffee places.
Okay.
And it was awesome. Like, I got blessing from all of them. I love them so much. You know, they welcomed me from the very beginning, and we had a great conversations, and you know, little expectations from both of them. Yeah, it went well, and I'm excited. I talked also to her brothers.
Oh, okay.
To her sisters, you know, like brothers, like too, like kind of like protect you. And
yeah,
like
yeah, so yeah, like, yeah, yeah.
So I asked them. Actually, I didn't have a chance to talk to her older brother, but I hope there will be still permission. And yeah, I got a yes from all of them. So I'm gonna wait for Austin. Yes, hopefully.
Hey, Austin. How did you guys meet?
It was around July 2013 when we met. I was working at Wegmans at the time as a cashier.
Okay.
And I normally only work the morning shift, but I picked up the shift to work the overnight. I remember I just did not want to be at work that day. I was just like so over it. For some reason, it just wasn't a good day. And I saw this handsome gentleman walk past, like just in the aisle. And there was like so many people, like from here to, I don't know, it was about like 15 feet, which is like a whole bunch of people in my line.
Right.
For some reason, I just looked up, caught his eye, and I was like,
so he stuck out.
Yeah, he did. And I don't know why, but like a little voice in my head was like, you need to do something about this. I just felt like really strong about like talking to him.
Okay.
I'm not the type to go out of my way to like approach a guy or anything like that. So it's definitely out of my character, but I just felt very, something significant about it. So I see him walking up. There's two lines open, me and then there's another lady there. I have like a ton of people, she only has two people. I'm like, oh, he's definitely gonna go into that line.
She didn't have anybody in her life.
Yeah, literally, it's open.
Okay.
I thought to myself, like, all right, if he comes to my line, I'll give him my number. But if he doesn't, then I just won't do it. And I was like, there's no way he's really gonna come here. So then he did, and I was like, oh, crap, I don't have to really do it. But this is just me, like, it's just in my head. But now I'm like, now I have to fall through. So beforehand, when I was thinking of this, because there was a gap in between when I saw him, when he actually came into my line, I took a blank sheet of like receipt paper and put my name, number, and a smiley face.
Oh.
And I just left it on the side. I was like, if he comes, I'll do it. And he walks up, he has his phone in his hand, and he's like doing something. And now I'm like messing up. Like I'm just like putting in wrong codes and stuff. I'm like all nervous for no reason. He had like something that we're supposed to say, like, did you find everything okay or whatever? And he just like looks up and he smiles. And I'm like, okay. And he didn't say anything. So I'm like, he's cute, he's a little weird. Like, why is he, like, you know? He starts putting his stuff on the thing and on the belt. And I'm like, you know, bagging his groceries and putting it at the top. And he's like taking it, moving to the bottom. I'm like, is he even bagging my stuff? Like, what's up? I was asking him some questions like, oh, you know, how's your day going or something like that. And he was just smiling. And I'm like, does he not talk? Like, what's up? After all that happened, I had to card him, and he was like, oh, my ID, and he had an accent. I was like, oh. I was like, maybe he didn't understand me. And I was like, okay, he's back.
Okay.
So then he showed me his passport, and we just started talking, like, having small talk, and people in the line are kind of like, can y'all hurry this up? Like, we're just having like a little heart to heart. Tell me he's from like a work and travel program and he lives in Slovakia and stuff like that. But he's here for the summer. So I'm like, well, that's cool, you know. So this whole time my heart is beating out of my chest, like, are you gonna do this or are you not gonna do this? And then at the very end, I just heard that voice again. I was like, just do it. Just give him the number. I'm like, oh. And I felt so embarrassed to do it. So I was like, all right, well, have a good day. And when I did it, I took the actual receipt and then I took the piece of paper, put it on top and handed it to him so he'd see it like faced up. And then he just turned like bright red and he was like, thank you.
Yeah, I was
like,
blushing so bad.
And I was like, oh gosh. A few minutes later, it felt like 10 minutes, but in his perspective, I guess it was like only two. My manager was in line buying groceries and stuff. I just feel like, you know, you feel somebody behind you.
Yeah.
So I'm kind of like, just look around. I'm like, wait, he's back. Why is he back? So I look back, I'm like, oh gosh, I hope he's not gonna be like, did you mean to give me your number? Like, what's this or that? You know, I was like, just nervous. So then my manager was like, who's that guy saying? That's your boyfriend? I'm like, oh, you know, maybe one day. I just try to like play it off. He walked up to me and he was like, oh, well, you know, thanks for giving me your number. I'll give you a call. I'm like, all right. I'm like, oh gosh, I can't.
I wanted to ask her to go out or just like, you know, do some pickup line or something, but
yeah.
I just like, my English back then, zero, so that's why I had these weird just smiles with no answers at the very beginning. So, and the lady actually from the other line, she was like, oh, honey, you can come here, you know, I'll do your groceries, and I was like, nah, I'm good here. So yeah, and I stayed there, and you know when you are in the long line and you are just like hanging, so you just lean on the cart, like, you know, with your elbows or something, and you type to your phone or something. So yeah, I was a little creep and I took a picture of her because I wanted to show my roommate that, you know, such a beautiful girl I saw and stuff like that. And yeah, it ended up that she was giving me a number and I, and yeah.
5 years later, you guys are sitting here together.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's, we went a long way, and yeah, it's awesome that she was bold enough to obey that little voice in her head and give me the.
And I always think about that. I'm like, what would have happened if I didn't? Like, would he have ended up doing it or not? But I feel like God kind of works things out in an interesting way where he gave me the boldness where maybe he was shy that day where normally I would never do it. So now looking back on it, I'm like, man, like, that's crazy. When we first met, it was maybe a month after knowing you. We officially started dating, and when he moved back to Slovakia after the summer, we Skyped every day for like 9 months. So we're long distance for a while. We were trying to talk and like the, you know, the communication be distorted, but we'd like make sure we talk every day, Mm-hmm. So
I don't think so there was a day we missed Skype.
No, there wasn't.
Like, even for 5 minutes, like, we saw each other.
Mm-hmm. You learn a lot in that time period if you really want to be with somebody long distance, and especially only knowing each other for like a month and a half or 2 months.
You came out of your way. You sat down to speak to me. What amazing grace you've shown, so patiently, and you waited for me, just for me. Oh, you called out my name. My shame. This amazing grace you've shown so patiently. You waited for me. Where would I be if you left me, God? Where would I be? Lift it up now, if you left me. I don't wanna know.
So you guys are engaged now.
Yeah, buddy!
How do you feel?
Yo, I'm feeling like, you know.
Martin, you have all that stress off your shoulder now. You can relax.
I literally am in disbelief. It was absolutely perfect. Just how I imagined it.
Now you guys gotta get married tomorrow.
Yeah,
Martin and Austin, if you guys are watching, I just wanna thank you for allowing me and honoring me to be part of your story. And I wish you guys nothing but the best for your future. I hope that God bestows many blessings on you guys. I'm so excited to see what the future holds for you guys. True, authentic love is such a beautiful thing, and at times it can be hard to find. I love to see when people love each other for who they are, not for what they look like or what they have. And Martin and Austin are true examples of what real love looks like. I'm gonna stop talking before I start crying. I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.